In this video, I'm going to show you how you can get an overview of any topic using InfraNodus, the visual text analysis tool that I developed. Here, I have Google search results for acupuncture, which are visualized with InfraNodus. InfraNodus lets me see what are the main topics inside, how they connect to one another, and also what are the interesting concepts that are relevant to this original search query. So for example, when I made a search on acupuncture, I can see that chronic pain is something that comes up a lot. And then if I click on those two nodes and I get into search results, I can see the specific search results which have this combination of words in them. So this is also a really great way to find the stuff that I'm interested in by just looking at the graph and identifying the clusters that are relevant. So for example, here, if I see an article that I like, then I can click on the link button and then this article will be open and then I can see how acupuncture can be used in treatment of migraine headaches, for instance, right? So this is something that I could also use to find search results. Also, if you do search engine optimization, this is really useful because you see directly what are the search terms that exist in relation to this query already on the market, so the current informational supply. And this allows you to see how you can fit in with your content in order to respond to all the different needs that people might have. So for instance, if you're creating a website on acupuncture and you see that there is some content on needle dynamics, cancer care, pain management and licensing rules, and you want to be at the top of search results, then you probably need to touch upon all those topics. But there's also one little secret that InfraNodus has that can improve your search result positioning much more, and this is in the content gaps. So if you click on the content gaps, InfraNodus identifies the gaps between the topics that others are not bridging yet. And this is an opportunity for you to create the maximum informational gain in the search results. So that means that you can maybe write content, or if you're researching this topic, write a research on this topic in the way that would bridge those different clusters together. So for example, here, there's something about needles and cancer care, and these two clusters are not so well connected. So then you can generate a research question that would bridge this gap using the built-in AI, and then it might inspire you to think about an article idea that would connect those two topics together, or you can also click elaborate and then explore it in more detail using the AI and generate some interesting ideas for how you can actually connect those content gaps and bridge them with new interesting ideas. So this can also be really useful if you want to develop new ideas and if you want to do it in a way that touches upon the subjects that are somehow relevant already for Google, but that connect them in new ways. So this is a very interesting way how you could apply it as well if you want to optimize your content and make sure that it reaches your audience. Now I'm just going to show you how you can do that. So you go to the apps page in InfraNodus, you open apps, and then you click on Study Market and SEO Analysis tab, and then you just type in the search query. So for instance, here I'm going to be using acupuncture, and I go to Google search, and here I give a name to this graph, and then I choose that I will import the top 40 search results. I can also say that I want them to be from another country. Here I'm using US English, but you can also use French from France, for example, and so on, doesn't matter. Then you click visualize. What happens is that InfraNodus ingests top 40 search results from Google. The words are the nodes, co-occurrences are the connections. You can also actually switch it to process only entities that it finds in text, but I like to use words because especially for search engine optimization, it's much more useful. And then you can see that there are, for example, main topics like treatment and pain. So there's a lot of results on pain treatment for this topic, right? And then there's also some instructions on how you insert needles. So then you understand very quickly, just from looking at the graph, what the content is like in relation to acupuncture. And if you're interested to explore this topic more, you can just zoom in onto those specific results, like I showed before, open the specific snippets of text where they are contained, and then you click on the link, and then you open the research paper, which is talking about this particular application. For instance, here, how to insert needles, right? But then it also gives you a really nice bird's eye view of the main ideas inside, and it's also really good if you just want to have a general overview of the results that already exist. And then you can do all these things like I discussed just before, that you can identify content gaps and then generate some interesting research questions based on them using these features in the analytics panel. And also what you can do is to look at the keyword relations here, which is quite useful because if you want to focus on a specific aspect, for instance, you're really interested about this needle insertion topic, then you can click on those two and you see what other concepts they connect to. And this allows you to explore this knowledge in much more detail. So you can really use this representation to both zoom out and have a general bird's eye view of a topic by just looking at the main ideas, or you can also zoom in into the specific concepts and then see how you can explore them in more detail by looking at search results that are specific to the concepts which you selected. So this is how it works. Like, you can get both a general overview and also get into the specifics. And one last thing I want to show you is that actually InfraNodus automatically removed the search term from the graph. So if you get it back into the graph, look what happens. It will take too much attention because it's contained in almost any search result. So this is why when it visualizes the results, it actually removes your search query. So it hides it from the graph, so it shows the context around it. And this is much more useful because you get a much better overview of the main ideas around. But you can also apply this approach as well when you analyze the results. So for instance, if at some point you understand that, okay, a lot of results are about pain treatment, you can actually select those two and also hide them from the graph to see what's hiding around them. And for example, here you see that the most specific topics are migraine, headache, treatment, right? So you can select those nodes and see the specific results that contain them and then explore these more detailed results. And as you know, people don't really click below the third Google result. So this is also a great way to find nuanced topics which are not normally available to you through Google. So I also like it as a way of searching for new interesting content. I hope you find it useful. Please let me know if you have any questions or comments in the comments to this video below. Thank you.